Hey y'all, welcome back to Poplar Creek Farm. Today is day 8 of the Whole30, so I wanted to give you guys a quick little update of how I'm doing. Today will actually probably be my last daily update for the Whole30. I probably will do every couple days, just so I'm not bombarding you guys with Whole30 videos every single day. But also, I think at this point, I don't think every day I'm going to feel a whole lot different. I think it's going to slow down the change. Last week, obviously, I felt pretty cruddy for a lot of the week, which is pretty, you know, normal and expected, being on a brand new diet. But I do want to give you guys kind of how I'm feeling and then also kind of why I chose Whole30 and why I think you guys can do it too. So today's Monday. I didn't sleep good last night and my back was hurting because my daughter was under my bed. So not the greatest day in the world, mostly because I was really tired. I mean, on Mondays, I'm typically, like, somewhat tired anyways. It's just Mondays. But I also am somebody who doesn't fall asleep well. I really have a hard time falling asleep. I can stay asleep. Once I'm asleep, normally I stay asleep pretty well. Last night was not a great stay asleep night either. But I really struggle to fall asleep. So that just, you know, kind of cascaded into not sleeping well and then being tired today. I don't think it's so much diet related. Again, also, my daughter came in my bed. She comes in my bed 95% of the nights, she comes in towards like the early morning hours, like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning most of the time, and then stays in my bed, which is my own fault, my bad habits that have led her to that. So, but that just, I'm just tired because of that. The diet overall, I felt really good. This morning I had a delicious omelet, which I'm not a big omelet person. Like, I just never really liked omelets. And I couldn't eat the whole thing, so I think I made it, it was too big. But I had 6 eggs, was the omelet, and then I had bacon, asparagus, and onions that I had, like, sauteed up before, put that in, and cooked it up, and it was delicious. And then I obviously had my morning kombucha, which I'm, like, swearing by now. I never thought I would drink kombucha. My sister has been drinking kombucha for years, and I tried it one time years ago, and I was like, oh, it's so gross, so nasty. It tastes like beer, and I don't like beer at all. I thought it was disgusting, but now I love it. Absolutely love it, and I drink it every day, most of the time twice a day. So I wish I had not. I wish I had, like, realized how good it was and how good it is for you before this point. But then I had for lunch, this is where my day kind of started to fall apart and I started to really crave some stuff. I was really craving chocolate again today, but again, not to the point, like, I've said this before, like, I'm not to the point of, like, where I actually am going to go out and, like, get chocolate. Like, I could, I mean, I'm an adult, I can do what I want, but I haven't gotten to that point yet. I haven't felt like I really, really need it. I just crave it. Yes, I want the taste of it, but do I need it? No. So for lunch, I did not plan well. I'm a home care nurse, and so I drive from house to house all day long, and most of the time I eat my lunches while I'm driving. Well, I brought soup. Soup, eating soup while driving, not exactly safe, and definitely not easy. And it was cold, because obviously I'm driving, I don't have, like, a microwave in my car, so it was not the greatest cold. It was kind of yucky. So I didn't really eat a whole lot of that. So then I just had my fruits and veggies. And then I was hungry, which obviously makes sense. Then when I got home, we ended up having turkey burgers for dinner. Obviously, I had it without the bun and without ketchup or anything. And then broccoli and cauliflower, as well as some sweet potatoes sauteed. So I officially, like, I used to always bake sweet potatoes. That was, like, the way I cooked them. That was the only way I cooked them. Or, if anything else, I would slice them and then put, like, loads of butter and brown sugar on them. And, like, candy them, which is not healthy. It pretty much ruins the sweet potato, the healthiness of the sweet potato. But ever since I started putting them in a frying pan with just, like, a little bit of olive oil, I don't think I'll ever cook them any different. I mean, I will bake them some because I do like baked sweet potatoes. But they are the best this way. They are so delicious. It really is, like, a little bit of a treat because they're so good. So I absolutely love them that way. I will eat them all the time now. And I don't think I had any fruit. I haven't eaten anything else. Had a little bit more kombucha because Excuse me. Because I'm tired. And I need a little pick-me-up. Overall, like I said, I'm feeling really good. I have zero affiliation with the Whole30. I have nothing financially to gain from them. I have no affiliation whatsoever with them. And so for me to, like, promote this or, like, say that it's, like, really good and I really think you guys should do it is because I truly, truly believe it. I am somebody who, I've said this time and time again, and I will continue to say it, I do not stick with diets. If you talk to my mother, who I have tried to diet with numerous times, she will tell you, I fail. Or I cheat, and then I'm just cheating myself, because all I'm doing is I'm cheating to myself if I'm sneaking snacks. I'm cheating to myself. I'm not, what am I gaining by saying that I'm doing it? What am I gaining? Nothing. So, and I'm telling you 100%, I swear I have not cheated on this diet, and I feel so good because of that, because I can actually say that, like, and not be lying about it or anything, because a lot of times I would sneak, like, a cookie, or I'd sneak chocolate, or, you know, whatever throughout the day, and then be like, yeah, I ate healthy all day, like, I'm just cheating myself when I do that, and I'm not gonna do that this time. I really don't feel deprived, I don't feel like I'm starving myself, I don't feel like this is some super hard diet to stick with. So when I started this diet, when I wanted to start a diet, I realized that I had gained a lot of weight, my clothes were not fitting me, and I was really uncomfortable with myself. I just didn't like the way I looked, I didn't like the way I feel, the way I felt, I didn't like anything about it. So I started to look into some diets. I have counted calories so many times, and it never works. I never stick with it. I have done multiple different diets. South Beach diet, I've done the 21-day fix, which I would say out of any other diet that I've tried, 21-day fix is probably the easiest to stick with. But still, it's calories. Even though you're measuring out your containers, it's still calories. You're still ending up counting calories. And so I just don't want to do those. And my mom had done the Whole30, and so I was like, well, let me look into it. I texted my mom. I said, hey, can I borrow the book? And then I realized, you know, she was like, yeah, of course, and I'll do it with you. And but then I'm like, when am I going to see her? You know, I wanted to start something right away. I was feeling somewhat motivated, so I wanted to go ahead and just get started on a diet. So I went ahead and looked on Amazon. The book was 50% off, so I was like, well, perfect, I'll order it. And I ordered the cookbook, which I kind of regret ordering because it's a little bit fancier meals than I would do. So, but it did give me some ideas, I guess, just, like, the idea of a meal, and I've just tweaked it to what I will eat. I don't eat fancy meals. I don't, like, do fancy seasonings or anything. It's just not my type of cooking. But, so I looked through this book. When I got the book initially, actually, I was like, nope. There's no way I can do this diet. I know myself. I know what I will stick with, and I guarantee I can't do this. Guarantee I won't stick with it. Why did I even buy this book? I'm gonna be starving. I'm gonna feel so deprived. It's gonna be miserable. I can't stick with the diet for 30 days. Nope. Oh, this is a waste of $30. You know, it's stupid. Then I talked to my mom some more, and she's like, no, you really can do it. It's, you know, it's a good reset. It'll really help your body. Blah, blah, blah. So I was like, okay, fine. I'll do it. And I really started reading the book, and I think what changed my mind the most, other than my mom, was the fact that it goes day by day and tells you, like, how you're gonna feel. Hey, guess what? Day one, you're gonna feel great. Day two, you're gonna wanna eat everything under the sun, and you're gonna hate this diet. I think it was day, like, four or five or something. You're gonna wanna kill things. Like, you're gonna be in the worst mood. And it's so true. I mean, and that's how you feel on a lot of diets. But they don't, like, you don't have that expectation of, I'm going to feel this way. So having that expectation from the front, from the start, I'm like, okay, I know I'm going to feel kind of crappy at first. I know I'm going to be miserable. But look at day whatever, 8 or 9, and people are starting to feel really good. And by day 30, they're not craving. I want to feel that. I want to be there. So reading those day by days, I actually still go back and look at them. Like, how am I supposed to feel today? Oh yeah, that is exactly how I feel. Like, it's really mind-boggling to, like, see it in words. I don't know what it did to, how it helped me mentally, but it really did help me see that, yep, it's gonna stink for a bit, but it's gonna get better, and you're gonna stick with it. And having my mom motivate me, and even my husband, he wrote me a little note on my, I had like a menu out for the week last week, and having my husband write like, you're at day 5, good job, you look amazing, blah, blah, blah. Like, it just helps. It really does help to have that motivation. So that's why I'm hoping I can motivate someone else, because you will do this. You can do this. If I can do this, and I'm not somebody who says that for anything. If I can do it, you can do it. Because I do not stick with diets. I hate diets. I hate all diets. I don't stick with them. They're stupid. But this works. I really like it, and it works. So, what, Sadie girl? What? Dog is staring at me because I'm so excited. She thinks I'm nuts. Maybe a little bit nuts. Say, girl, am I crazy? Is mommy crazy? You hear her tail? She's back in the bed, whacking the phone. Come here, Stevie. Oh, she actually got really excited the other day when she saw that I had my running gear on because she's my running buddy. But I'm like, I'm not running outside. That's not happening right now. Hi, sweet girl. It's too cold for that. But guys, please, please, please give this a try. If you are wanting to have a full body reset, if your body isn't, like, if your GI system's off, if you're just not having energy, like, give this a try. Thank you guys for joining me today on my crazy little rant. Just remember, guys, we're growing today.
Full body tomorrow.
Please like and subscribe. You're doing good.